Welcome back to Tape Don't Lie. We've got Max Brown in the building. How you doing, Max?
The day has come, Mike. We're finally talking DBs for once. It's your alley today.
I'm so excited. We're going to hit on a couple different levels of the defense, but I'm glad to have you on. Talk DB, quarterback. Talk about what defensive backs mean and kind of what you're looking for when you look at these guys. And we're going to hit on Clemson's Kayvon Wallace. He is a player that I think is, one, the most underrated player on that defense, and two, a guy that I think has a bright future at the next level.
Yeah, I think you're looking for a guy that's jumping off the screen on tape, a guy that's making plays. He's around the ball. He's got good range in the back end. He's coming up and being physical in the run game. Kayvon Wallace does some of that. The size concerns are going to be there a little bit, but he's a player, and anytime you're a captain on a national championship winning football team, that's a good sign.
Yeah, I think let's get into how physical he could be. Despite the size concerns, he is a guy that wants to make tackles, a guy that is physical. 71 tackles right there, obviously one of their leading tacklers. But all these Clemson DBs, I mean, look at the three safeties, Wallace, Muse, and Turner. You can't play for Brent Venables if you don't tackle.
Yeah, and I think with Venables, he's a guy that does a lot defensively, and so you need a guy like Wallace who can jump around. He can play the back end safety. He can hop up in the box. He can play slot corner or nickel or something like that. The reality is you can tell they love Kayvon Wallace at Clemson, or they loved, I should say. He's around the ball a lot, and they're putting a lot on him mentally in terms of jumping around. And so I think when you talk about jumping to the next level, he's played in some NFL schemes, and that'll definitely serve him well when you compare him to some of the other safeties.
Yeah, he's number 12. We've seen number 11, Isaiah Simmons. He's a guy that a lot of people have in the top 10. But they used to flip them back and forth where Simmons would be back in the deep end so they could keep him towards the middle of the field, where Wallace would push out wide and then vice versa. So let's get into what he does in the run game. And I think that this is really, really something to see. And you see Kayvon Wallace right here. Watch the route that he takes. And this is just pure good football scraping to get to the quarterback.
Yeah, the route he takes and the word scrape you used, I mean, this is picture-perfect scraping right here. He's supposed to fill on the right side, the offense's right side. That's his lane. And he leaks over to his own right and is able to make a tackle. I think this just shows his range, shows his versatility. He's always attacking. He comes up and makes a good tackle. And I just think he's around the ball. That's something that sticks out. Not all these safeties. Some of these are ball-hawking guys. Some of these guys are playing center field. That's not Wallace. Wallace is around the rock, likes making those tackles, and that jumps off the screen.
Yeah, and then we've got him here playing on the inside of that bunch formation. And I love the disengage. There's one thing that an old DB coach told me. He said, you should never get blocked by a wide receiver. And I think Wallace really epitomizes the idea that I cannot be blocked by any wide receiver in the game.
Yeah, this is something that continues to jump out as well, as he's not the biggest guy. You'd think that he would get blocked here or there, but he has a knack for just getting off blocks. And it's maybe not the most technically sound all the time or the most physical all the time, but he has a knack for getting off blocks, making tackles. And I think when you talk about if you're going to ask him to play nickel at the next level or slot corner and fill a lot of run lanes and be the guy that's making tackles on bubble screens and RPOs, this is what you need out of your guy. And so I think this is a great showing from Wallace.
Yeah, I love it. Collision. He collisions. He forms up. And then I love him figuring out which side he has to disengage to. And we're going to get another one here. This is, again, he's playing. Look, he's in the box. They've got an 8-man box. You can't usually do that in college football anymore. And then he again, throws the guy and is able to go make a tackle. And it's always downhill, like you mentioned.
Always downhill, always disengaging. I mean, you talk about a guy that has high football IQ. He knows what the offense has given him. I think when you look at like intangibles, he kind of checks all the boxes there, but he has a knack for not getting blocked. That's a great sign if you're a defender.
Yeah, that is a huge part of playing defense, is somebody shedding a block and making a tackle, and that's what he does there. He sheds the block to make the tackle, obviously with his teammate Isaiah Simmons. So I think that for me really jumped off. When I was going through and trying to pull plays for Kayvon Wallace, I really wanted to show people the little stuff that doesn't go into a stat sheet, but shows up huge for scouts, huge for your football team, because he's active and because he will not allow himself to be blocked.
Without a doubt, and that's what he's gonna be asked to do. I think he's in the safety category when you talk about NFL projections, but he's going to be playing in the box. He's going to be playing a lot of nickel. That, to me, is how he's going to make a roster. And so that's what he's going to get asked to do day in and day out for whatever team takes a chance on him.
Yeah, and then we're going to get a chance to watch him play in pass coverage as well. And this is a guy that went out and got things done. You look at this, FBS players with 70-plus tackles and 10 passes defense. And obviously, like, you look at this, and he shows up. I mean, this guy checks the stat sheet. Obviously, had a couple interceptions to go with it, but he's always breaking up passes in addition to the tackling, the run defense that we saw.
Yeah, I love the way he plays in space, and it kind of goes hand in hand when with his knack to get off blocks and all that. But in terms of the pass game, I love him in the zone. He has a great feel for what's going on, what the offense is trying to do, and then breaking on the ball and getting a hand in there. That's what you want out of a DB. He had a lot of drop picks this past year, but hey, sometimes that happens. But as long as he's there, you got to like that.
Here he is at the top of the screen, and I love the way that the linebacker helps him, but the way his instant recognition of this and breaking on the ball, he's in the quarterback's mind. He knows what's happening. He knows what's coming. This tells me that he's a guy that not only can read quarterbacks, but he does his homework too. Like, that's a play. He recognizes the motion, recognizes the formation, and now he knows this is where they like to go.
Yeah, he knows they're trying to RPO him. I mean, first off, this is an absolutely terrible decision by the quarterback. But hey, if the quarterback's going to do that, you got to make him pay. He jumps on it. He recognizes what they're trying to do. And a lot of the plays we just saw previously, it's a lot of him sitting in the nickel. He's close to the line of scrimmage. Well, this is more of true safety. This is what you want to see. You want to see him back there in a safety position, reading the quarterback, reading the offensive line, jumping and knowing his keys. And these are game-changing plays. This changes the course of a game, puts your team up 14-0, and it's a big-time play for sure.
Yeah, I like him. And then we get a little bit of the speed here for him to go take that thing to the end zone, turning defense into offense, a little shimmy, a little shake to get into the end zone with his teammates. I really like that element of his game. The other thing I like is his awareness, that football IQ that we mentioned, recognizing sticks. He sits sticks and then drives down. I love that.
This is huge, and it goes right back to what I was saying about knowing what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to, if you're the quarterback in me, you're going to throw this slant, you're going to fall forward for six, pick up the first down, and move on. Well, not so fast. I mean, Wallace, he'll give you the inside, but he's making tackles. That's one thing that continually shows up is he's not getting beat or not having arm tackles and getting worn through. This is a great job. It's a great job understanding football awareness, knowing where the sticks are. And once again, we're seeing him in that slot corner, which is where I think he's going to make his living at the next level.
Yeah, I think in recognizing down and distance and understanding I'm going to sit here before I drive on that big play. And then here we got Kendall Hinton on the run. And again, a little bit more of that speed, right? Hinton is a fast player, and Wallace is able, even though he's out of position early, he's able to go out there and clean up this mess and save a touchdown.
And there's probably some GMs around the country that are trying to time this on the screen right here. What's his football speed? What's his 40-yard dash? And moving forward to this spring and the combine and whatnot, how he tests will be a big deal. The reality is he is not a big safety, so he is going to have a little bit more of that speed and ambition to see what he tests at, but you talked about his mentality, the intangibles I touched on. Well, not giving up on the play, hunting down an athletic quarterback, it's a great sign. And that's the reason why he's probably a captain on this team, those characteristics, those traits. And I have a feeling some team's going to fall in love with him because of that.
Yeah, I think that obviously Darren Kendrick and A.J. Terrell are the lead dogs out of that Clemson secondary in terms of names people know. But when we get to Tanner Muse and we get to Kayvon Wallace, I think there are two guys that are going to be battling not just for roster spots, but ultimately it's going to be really tough at the next level if they get with the right system to keep them off the field.
Without a doubt, it'll be interesting to see if he gets to the defensive corner that calls on a lot of zone concepts rather than man concepts. That could play the difference for him. But with where he's going to be at, he's going to have to get it done on special teams at the next level and find his role. But definitely a guy who Clemson fans love, football fans love, and should have a great shot in the NFL.
Yeah, I'm glad you hit on special teams. Can you talk to folks about how important that is? Because with a player like him, obviously we're talking about him playing sort of that nickel corner spot, playing that inside safety, but the reality is he's going to be on those four cores.
Oh, yeah. That's his ticket, right? Anytime you're a safety or a nickel linebacker, that's how you make the squad. It's only a 53-man roster. This isn't college where you got almost 100 guys or 80 guys traveling. You got to get it done on special teams. But because of his mentality, because of the effort we just saw in a last play like that, he reminds me of a guy that's going to welcome the special teams challenge and get it done on all KOR, kickoff, punt return. Wallace will get it done for sure.
Yeah, he's going to work on those four core. Last thing for me, Max, when you look at this Clemson defense, how hard, realistically looking forward, how hard do you think it's going to be to replace all these dogs?
It's going to be tough, but Brent Venables continues to do it year in and year out. I think 2 years ago the conversation was how they're going to replace this defensive line. Well, they found a way, and they replaced it with a great, great secondary. This year, having to place a lot of people in the secondary might lean on the front seven guys some more, but anytime you're recruiting the way Clemson is, Mike, I envision we'll be talking about him all year long.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it, Max. Thank you so much. Looking forward to watching Kayvon Wallace in Indy as well.